हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, या आई एम राजेश कुमार सिंह, योर इंग्लिश टीचर। वी आर गोइंग टू रीड नेक्स्ट लेसन ए पीस ऑफ पोएट्री फोटोग्राफ। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लेसन दैट इज ए पोएम ऑफ और पोएट्री पार्ट, वी मस्ट नो व्हाट इज पोएट्री। वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, एज पोएट्री कम्स फ्रॉम आवर इमोशंस, आर इन अदर वर्ड्स दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ आवर वेरी हार्ट। एज one of a great poet of English literature, Arnold defines it as poetry is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings, means poetry is a natural overflow of our feelings when they are filled, and now they are becoming so much that our heart is not going to contain in our heart, then those emotions start to overflow from the medium of the pen of poet. A poet starts to write those things and express them in the language such a way. Thus, when he describes a spontaneous overflow, a overflow that takes place naturally without the bond of language, grammar or other things, and those feelings are very powerful, they are able to steer our emotions. It often releases from the poetic heart when it has some stimulus worthy to be contemplative on some pitiful thought, object or emotions. Some object or thing who are closely related to our near and dear one are able to put our emotions, that is heart, in the ocean of sweet ancient past memory and make it lost for a while. Students, before starting the topic, let's know something about the poetess Shirley Toulson. Shirley Toulson, a British poetess, was a poet, teacher, educational journalist, editor, and the author of books about walks along the ancient tracks and roads of Britain. Naturally, you can understand about the poetic temperament of the poetess and her habit, as walking was a lifelong delight. Walking was a lifelong delight for the poetess. It was slight. As slight means when we sometimes do some work, those words are something offensive for others. For example, suppose that today the women are putting some new garments which are the example of modern fashion, modern trends. Those things are something offensive for the old-minded people. The ladies put on those garments, but the offense takes place in the heart of old-minded people of the society. This is the meaning of slight. Here, walking was a lifelong delight for the lady. She was an outspoken lady, and thus, you can say her personality, her activities being slight, but she was agile and with impressive stamina. She walked in all withers every mile of the Roman roads and forgotten trade roads of Britain. She rode East Anglia, walking the ley lines and ancient tracks, published in 1979, and The Drovers, published in 1980. She died after a long healthy life in the age of 93 years.
The topic, a photograph. A photograph also deals with such object which makes the poetess lost in the sweet memory of her dead mother. When she sees the picture of her dead mother in her young age on one of the holidays at sea beach, she finds herself lost in the past memory.
Students, see the reading of first stanza. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girls' cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and see the big girl, some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. A sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born, and the sea, which appears to have changed less, was their terribly transient fate. Now, see the explanation. The cardboard, the picture of the poetess mother, shows the look of her mother in her young age, in the company of two cousin girls. They are at the sea beach, that is the seashore, where often we go to enjoy the holidays. They are at the sea beach on one of her holiday along with them. The picture shows that the girls are holding the hands of the poet's mother, walking on shallow water of the sea beach. The girls look happy with a smiling face. The big girl was 12 years old, and so was the other. The two cousin girls stood along the mother to give a shot with a sighful smile through their hair to the uncle's camera. The uncle was standing with a camera to have a shot of the three. Now the poetess find herself drifted in the sweet memory of the past, when her mother was a pretty woman with a beautiful face. She had a sweet face. It was the time when the author was not born. From that time to till this time, there has been no change in the look of the sea. Though there has been a lot of change in the life of the poetess as well as in the life of her mother, but in comparison of these two, there was no change in the sea. It appears changeless, and if it, it is less, and it washed the unstable, that is, always walking the feet of the girls. Let's see the second stanza. Some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. See Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter. Both re with the labored edge of loss. Now, let's have its explanation. The picture of the mother was shot 30 years ago. And after 30 years later, when she saw her own snapshots, she would laugh at it as she was a child. She would say that she, Betty and Dolly, had dressed her for the holiday on the beach. It was the fashion of the day and the mother looks in it. Now, to entertain herself at the sea beach on the holiday had passed. Now her joy had got the limitation. It was limited to the happiness of her child, that is, daughter. She smiles at the love and happiness of her own daughter. Both the daughter amuses themselves at this labor loss picture. Students, see the last stanza. Now, she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. And of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. It's silence. As the last stanza deals with the thought of the author's, that is, the poet's mother's death. When the thought of her mother's death occurs in her mind, she finds a great change in her temperament. As the picture shows, the picture of young children, and now the mother had been dead for the years as much as she looks in the photograph. It means the mother died long ago. Now in this circumstance, the poet looks at the mother in silence, the silence of death. She does not want to talk or speak anything, but she prefers to live in silence, the silence that gives birth to the absolute reality of the life and world. Some evaluation questions. When the photograph has been taken and where? Question number second. How does the mother look in the picture? Third, what is the mother's opinion about her dressing for the holiday on beach? And fourth, why does the poetess say that there is nothing to say at all? Yes, some difficult words. A cardboard, an unreal picture, or image, or photograph. Paddling, to walk on foot in shallow water. Transient means unstable. Moving continuously, you can understand it. re an expression of amuse in sad temperament. Thanks, students. You will see you again in next video.